Hello everyone, and welcome to today's webinar titled Complete Workflow Solution from Gene to Protein. I am Michelle Ashton of LabRoots, and I'll be your moderator for today's event. Today's educational web seminar is presented by LabRoots and brought to you by Thermo Fisher Scientific. To learn more, visit thermofisher.com. We encourage you to participate today by submitting any questions you may have during the presentation. To do so, simply type them into the Ask a Question box and click Send. All of your questions will be followed up via email following the broadcast. You may also submit any technical issues here as well if you have trouble seeing or hearing the presentation. I'd like to now welcome our speaker, Dr. Stefan Pfaff, Protein Service Group Manager at Thermo Fisher Scientific. Welcome. You may now begin your presentation.
Good morning, good afternoon to all attendees, and thank you for joining this webinar event. My name is Stefan Pfaff. I'm a manager in manufacturing in the bioscience divisions of Thermo Fisher Scientific, and currently I'm heading the protein service group at the Chinat site in Regensburg, Germany. And as mentioned by the title of this presentation, today I would like to talk about strategies for high titer protein expression using highly advanced expression systems with expression optimized genes. Before that, I would like to start with our mission at Thermo Fisher Scientific, which is to enable our customers to make the world healthier, cleaner, and safer. And this especially holds true in this age and time of a global pandemic, where we support our customers in their efforts against the COVID-19 pandemic. Just as an example, here at Chinat, we are supporting this fight against the COVID-19 disease, as we already produce several thousand genes, as well as some proteins for vaccine development or for molecular diagnostics. I would like to start with a quick look at the agenda and what will be covered during today's talk. I'm going to start out with a brief overview of Chinat services and talk about some key application of synthetic genes. Before then, I will briefly talk about gene synthesis and introduce you to our multi-parameter optimization approach and how this approach benefits protein expression. In the second part, I will show that we have access to the highest titer systems on the market, as we are partnering with the CellBio and with the Gibco team of Thermo Fisher Scientific, as we utilize the XP293 and XPCHO protein expression platforms. And finally, I will introduce our gene-to-protein service, and by doing this, I will demonstrate how your research can benefit from combining those advanced expression systems with expression-optimized genes, and how we can support your research by offering a complete workflow solution from gene to protein. So the service offering provided at Chinat covers the full workflow from gene to protein, or if requested, only parts of this work. All you need is submit or provide a digital DNA or amino acid sequence, and several days later you will receive a highly expressed, purified, and analyzed protein to your door. And in addition to pure gene synthesis or protein services, we can also provide you with gene variants, or we can build whole complex gene libraries, providing technology which enables options to adapt protein properties to your specific needs. And this comprehensive product and service portfolio all comes from one hand. Everything we do is done in-house, so there is no need of material or data transfer, which is very crucial for many of our pharma and biotech customers. And of course, we are committed to do our work to the highest quality standards, and we have a quite easy to order process via a web-based ordering platform or via a very dedicated customer care team. So key applications for synthetic genes, of course, are manifold. They can range from basic research to cell line optimization. Synthetic genes play a role in genetic engineering, in gene therapy. But during today's talk, I would like to focus on their use for transient expression, and especially for antibody optimization and antibody or protein production. So Usually, gene-to-protein services, they start entirely from scratch, as gene synthesis meanwhile became state-of-the-art since it is a very cost-effective and time- and resource-saving method. So here at GNUT, we are considered as the excellent center for writing DNA, offering a world-class optimization technology with significant production capacities. So just as an example, we have production capacities for over 30,000 oligos a day, and we are producing more than 11 megabase pairs or more than 11,000 genes a month. And of course, all of those synthetic genes are sequence verified according to newest next gene sequencing technology with capacities of more than 28,000 sequence reads a day. And again, your synthetic gene is only built based on a digital sequence, which is provided by you as the customer. It then will be cloned, for example, in our pcDNA 3.4 protein expression vector, which is optimized for best performance. And then it can be immediately used for protein production. So if your interest is protein production, why should you then go with an optimized gene? And one reason for sure, and this has been for many, many years, is that, of course, codon usage affects protein expression. So while you have a genetic code that is universal, you have 61 codons that code for only 20 amino acids. And out of those 20 amino acids, 18 amino acids use synonymous codons. And those alternative codons, again, are used with an unequal frequency. And in addition to that, the codon usage patterns differ in each and every organism. So apparently, if you recall critical steps during protein expression, the codon usage of the transgene plays a critical role as it has to match the tRNA availability of the host cell. But of course, especially in mammalian cells, gene expression is a much more complex process, and it is influenced by many additional factors, such as, for example, GC content, direct repeats, or RNA secondary structures, which can be huge obstacles for the ribosomal machinery during the translational process. So if you take a look now at this aligned sequence on the left of this slide, which should represent a wild-type sequence here, you can see that this sequence might not be optimal for protein expression since it contains some unfavorable codons which are highlighted here in red. So what you could do now is you could do a simple codon backtranslation by simply replacing those unfavorable codons in red by the most favorable codons for the given expression host, which are highlighted here in green. But such a simple codon backtranslation might also not be optimal for protein expression, as you might introduce additional unwanted motifs such as repetitions or any secondary structures, which in the end then might hamper protein expression. So the goal always is you need to find a trade-off between codon optimization and those additional motifs which are influencing protein expression. And this is why our IT software engineers developed an algorithm which is not a simple codon optimization, but actually is an RNA optimization, which takes up to 20 parameters into account in order to optimize a mammalian coding region. So how do you solve now such a multi-parameter optimization problem, which of course can be a huge mathematical problem, just considering a gene which codes for a protein with 100 amino acids? It is simply impossible to analyze to analyze all possible codon combinations. And this again is why our IT software engineers here at GNUT developed the so-called sliding window approach. And what this approach does, it actually does test all possible codon combinations. However, it only does this in a very limited window of 10 to 20 amino acids. Within this window, the very best codon combination is created, the very first codon is locked down, and then this window slides or moves along your sequence from the 5 prime to the 3 prime end of your gene, and the whole process is done over and over again. And by doing this, your optimized sequence is constantly growing. And obviously, of course, furthermore, an extended window is considered for evaluating the best codon combination, just to ensure that at later time points, you're not introducing again any motifs such as secondary structures, which might be hampering protein expression. So when it comes to the production of human proteins, of course, production of human recombinant proteins became an indispensable process in modern biotechnology and biomedicine. By far, mammalian and E. coli hosts are the most prominent expression systems for this purpose. The advantages for E. coli are obvious. It's fast growing, it's easy to handle, it's very cheap and basically a completely understood organism. However, E. coli expression also has several disadvantages, severe disadvantages, such as the lack of post-translational modifications. You don't have a suitable membrane environment for membrane proteins. Overexpression of your protein might lead to misfolding and aggregation, which requires then a lot of efforts to resolubilize your protein from inclusion bodies. And of course, you are very restricted on large size and oligomeric proteins. And finally, if it comes to the production of antibodies, it's simply impossible to produce an authentic human glycoprotein. And according to this, more than 70% of recombinant protein pharmaceuticals and most proteins used for vaccination, human therapy, or diagnostics are currently produced in mammalian cells. Simply circumvents all those obstacles of E. coli expression. This leaves only the question why then optimization is still required for the production of a human protein in an autologous host. And the answer is quite simple, since nature did not optimize genes for maximum expression, but rather for maximum regulation. And so you're still facing severe obstacles for protein expression, such as transcriptional silencing, mRNA destabilization, splicing events, premature polyadenylation events, or simply a very inefficient translational process. So apparently all problems of gene expression can find their source in the transgene itself. And this is why we believe that gene optimization is one first step to overcome any protein expression problems. And to prove that our optimization approach, our optimization algorithm is working, we conducted a first large-scale study addressing the influence of multi-parameter optimization on an autologous, in an autologous host for human protein expression. And what we did here is we simply chose 50 standard human genes from the NCBI data bank, which are representing the most interesting protein classes. Among them were kinases, transcription factors, ribosomal proteins, cytokines, and membrane proteins. And then we de novo synthesized those proteins as optimized as well as wild-type constructs. And then we transfected them, those constructs, into HEK293 cells in triplicates and basically made a head-to-head comparison of wild-type versus optimized expression. And as you can see here on this slide, the optimized construct basically outperformed their wild-type counterparts in each and every case. So the result of the study was that in 96% of cases, the optimized construct showed at least equal expression as the wild-type counterpart, while indeed in 86% of proteins, the optimized construct significantly showed better expression performance. We only had two cases, two membrane proteins, where apparently based on Western blot analysis, the wild-type construct showed a better expression result. But we believe that this was due to a toxic effect that was introduced to the cells by overexpressing the membrane protein in the cell membrane, and that this was the reason for this result. Okay, so this slide basically shows additional expression data where we tested three intracellular proteins and now also two antibodies, which were optimized with our gene optimizer algorithm for expression in human cells. As you can see, wild-type expression levels were normalized to 1, and if you take a look now at those two antibodies, protein expression yields increased by 12 to 15 times simply by optimizing the respective heavy and light chain genes of those two antibodies. And finally, of course, we also wanted to benchmark our optimization approach to other algorithms which are out in the field. And in order to do this, we chose a set of kinases, again, De novo synthesized those kinase genes as optimized and wild-type genes. Did a head-to-head comparison on expression level, but this time we also compared expression levels to wild-type levels of targets that were optimized by our competitors. And as you can see, or what this study revealed is, that our gene optimizer technology was the only technology that consistently provided higher expression levels compared to wild type, which again is demonstrating its high reliability and high performance for protein expression. Our gene optimizer technology provided the best results for those kinases which were tested, while none of our competitor approaches showed a reliable expression performance, as they failed at least for one or the other gene in order to deliver better expression results in comparison to wild-type expression. So apparently, we have a very good tool here in hand, and now we want to combine this tool with the benefits of those advanced expression systems which are available through Thermo Fisher Scientific, which is the XP293 and the XP-CHO expression platform. So obviously, protein expression plays a role in many workflows, such as structural biology, assay development, or early biologics development. And classically, for years, 293 cells have frequently been used in early biologics development due to previous difficulties in CHO cells when you perform transient expression, so which often yielded in very low titers of 10 to 20 milligrams per liter only. So this example workflow here now illustrates how our XP systems are facilitating the development of monoclonal antibodies and vaccines. In case of monoclonal antibodies during early development stages, where groups are still screening antibodies to select candidates for downstream development, researchers often use transient systems to accelerate access to protein. And once a candidate is selected, typically a CHO cell line is made for development and commercialization purposes. However, during those development phase, due to low yields from CHO cells in the transient mode, typically the early screening would have to be done in HEK293 cells or in a HEK293 host. And then the candidate would have to be switched again into a CHO cell line for stable development, which is clearly far from being optimal. So what we see today is that those XP systems play a major role in these early development stages, as they allow groups now to choose between a CHO or a HEK host for early screening purposes. And we have seen that access to a high yield expression XP CHO system enables groups now to start screening in CHO cells and continue development in CHO from discovery to animal trials, which is, of course, a major game changer over the past few years. So apparently, our strategy to increase transient protein yields would be to combine those highly advanced expression systems with our expression optimized genes that we talked about before. So we talked a lot about the advantages of gene optimization, consistently providing higher expression levels compared to wild type. And obviously, we have a very reliable optimization approach, which is apparently a world-class approach beating out our competitors. The advantages of the XP systems are that these systems are coming basically as a kit and is completely commercially available through Thermo Fisher Scientific. And this kit contains culture medium that achieves threefold higher cell densities. It contains cells that are adapted to express more protein per cell. It contains transfection reagent that effectively delivers DNA into those high cell density cultures, and the protocol directly plugs into our user's current 5-to-7 workflow. So what this slide here shows now are how high density culture media supports high cell densities. So what is shown in red here is our XP293 cells, which are growing in XP293 media. And this is compared to HEK cells, which are growing in a variety of other medias. And what you can see is that the maximum densities are much, much higher, meaning that early to mid log phase growth is in a totally different working range. So the working range up to mid log phase allows you to maintain those cells up to 6 million cells per milliliter. Then usually you simply passage or dilute your cells and you are able to transfect your cells at a density of 3 million cells per milliliter, while typically other HEC formats only allow transfection at 1 million cells per milliliter. And XPCHO allows to grow those cells even to higher densities. And typically in XPCHO, you are able to transfect your cells at a density of 6 million cells per milliliter. And then in the end, it's a quite easy calculation. You have cells which are adapted for higher protein performance, protein yields. The cells are growing to higher densities. And this means you have more cells producing protein, and this simply is supporting your high expression yields. So next, let me jump into some of the expression data. And actually, this is data which was generated internally and is comparing XP293 expression system to conventional culture systems, such as the Invitrogen freestyle expression system. And what we observed was a 2- to 10-fold higher protein expression performance using the XP293 system over those conventional HEC293 systems. We even achieved expression levels up to 1 gram per liter for individual IgG formats. And the XPCHO expression system shows even superior expression levels compared to existing transient systems. So what this slide compares are recombinant protein titers of a human IgG, a rabbit IgG, and a non-antibody format, which was EPO. And those were expressed in freestyle CHO, XP293, and the XPCHO transient expression system. And as you can see, the XPCHO system exceeded the freestyle CHO system for this human IgG by a factor of 160. And it also exceeded those other formats by factor 2 to 4 when compared to the XP293 system. This slide shows a panel of rabbit monoclonal antibodies which were tested in XP293 and XPCHO using a max titer protocol. And this yielded in a 1.4 to 3.9-fold expression improvement over the XP293 system. So what you also can see is that one monoclonal MAP19 did not express at all in the XP293 system, but it still delivered a decent expression level of approximately 82 milligrams per liter in the XPCHO system. We also had one candidate, monoclonal 20, which did not express in neither system. And as to why, this is still unclear at this time, but what is certain is that all of those rabbit monoclonals share the same vector backbone with the exception of their CDRs. And so you also can see here the significant differences solely in the impact of different CDRs for protein expression levels. And finally, this slide shows additional expression data comparing XP293 and current expression system versus the XPCHO system. And among, again, human IgGs, rabbit IgGs, but also mouse IgGs, and a broad range of non-antibody proteins were tested and all showed basically lower titers than in comparison to the XPCHO system. So also during this study, we observed expression level increases using the XPCHO system for IgG titers by a factor of 0.6 to approximately 100-fold. With that, I would like to move on introducing our gene-to-protein service. And our service offering here at GeneArt offers the full workflow from gene synthesis to protein production as a complete workflow solution using those advanced XP293 and XPCHO systems. So here at GeneArt, we strongly focus on mammalian protein production as those systems deliver the highest quality proteins with the most proper function. And as most of our customers are pharma and biotech customers who are interested in antibody production, those are certainly the best systems for this purpose, as they are the highest titer system on the market. So we can act as an extension of your lab. If you are using the XP293 in CHO system for your research, and we certainly have the expertise with those systems, so customers who need to outsource protein production can be confident they get very consistent and high performance results. So once again, I would like to point out that our gene-to-protein service completely is done in-house, which provides full control for you as a customer, but also for us as a manufacturer, which is very crucial for many of our pharma and biotech customers. But of course, we are also closely collaborating with the Gibco and CellBio teams of Thermo Fisher Scientific, and we are often serving as alpha customers for new developments on the market. So if you order a gene-to-protein service, you have the full design flexibility for your project. So you can choose, for example, between a HEK and a CHO expression system if you are interested in a specific glycosylation pattern for your antibody, for example. And of course, we are also very customized regarding the purification strategy for your proteins. I also want to mention that upstream of our protein department, we have highly specialized manufacturing departments who deliver high quality plasmid preparations. And of course, as part of Thermo Fisher Scientific, we have access to the entire in vitro gen vector suite. But usually using those XP system, our plasmid, expression plasmid, is the PCDNRS 3.4 vector, which is adapted for highest performance in those XP system. Regarding expression capabilities, also here we are very flexible with regard to scales. I will talk about this in just one or two slides later. We are very experienced with parallel workflows for high throughput production of proteins. So for example, if you have multiple targets to be produced, and yeah, as extensively talked before now, we of course have the highest titer systems on the market using the XP expression system. Regarding purification, we use state-of-the-art equipment, so we have multiple ECTA FPLC devices for parallel purifications, and we have constantly growing capacity. So last year alone, we produced more than 5,000 antibodies at various scales, plus an additional approximately 500 non-antibody formats. And depending on your needs, we can make things happen quite quickly as we are part of such a big organization, which is Thermo Fisher Scientific. And finally, your protein also will be analyzed, of course, according to your needs. And we have state-of-the-art analytical capabilities, which can be very basic, basic protein biochemistry, such as an SDS shell and a Western blot. But of course, we also have advanced analytical capabilities, such as capillary gel electrophoresis to determine purity of your protein. We can do analytical gel filtration via HPLC to determine monomer content of your antibody. We can do endotoxin detection and so on. So this slide, I don't really want to go into too much detail here because it's a very busy slide, but what it highlights is basically an example workflow for a mammalian protein production project. Basically, what I only would like to mention here is that we offer different service types where you can order basically protein production from a specified culture volume, or you can order a specified amount of protein that usually requires a pilot production upfront, in order also to deliver full transparency for you as a customer. Also, as you can see in this slide, we have several decision points where you as a customer can decide how to move on with your protein request, even after the actual production already has started. So, gene to protein expression scales, I mentioned it before, we are very flexible and extensible. So what we offer here is What we offer here is production of protein from 30 milliliter up to 3 liter in shaker flasks. However, we also have the capacity to produce 25 liter production in wave bioreactors. And depending on the product mix, we currently have capacity to produce more than 300 liter of suspension culture in shaker flasks per week, plus an additional 100 liter, actually it's 125 liter of wave bioreactor culture per week. And what is our newest service offering, which will probably be launched in June, officially launched in June, but this is already offered to customer, is our high throughput, small scale expression format in 24 to 96 multi-well format. And this is especially for customers who don't need a lot of protein for their research purposes, but yeah, they need microgram to lower milligram range of protein, for example, for initial screening purposes. With regard to expression systems, we talked about that extensively. We are focusing on the XP293 and XP-CHO systems, since those are the highest titer systems which are on the market. But we also offer SF9 insect cell production using the bug-to-bug baculovirus expression system. And I also want to mention that all of those reagents are commercially available, so you can replicate your work later in-house, which also provides full transparency of our processes. With regard to purification of your protein, again, we are a very customized service provider. We produced more than 5,000 protein productions last year, and usually, if it's a standard workflow, usually we start with an initial capture step using affinity chromatography. I mean, yeah, using protein A, G, if it's an antibody purification. But of course, we can also use a whole variety of epitope tags for non-antibody formats, classically a His tag, a Strep tag. But we also use these newer nanobody technologies, for example, a C tag. And we are also very experienced in the production of antibody formats such as FAPs or fusion proteins, as well as the production of bispecifics. After an initial capture step, we could do intermediate purification. This usually would be ion exchange chromatography step, and final polishing step always is a gel filtration or a size exclusion chromatography to determine or to deliver, for example, an antibody at highest quality. Again, with regard to capacity, depending on the product mix in production, we are able to deliver more than 300 antibody purifications a week up to a certain culture scale. And as mentioned before, we are flexible and our capacities are constantly growing. Also, another slide highlighting our analytical capabilities. I also mentioned before, it could be a simple protein biochemistry, such as an SDS page, a Kumasi stain shell, and a Western blot. Of course, always protein concentration is delivered using nanotrop measurements, but we also have advanced capabilities for analytics, such as capillary gel electrophoresis using a lab chip device, or we have several HPLC devices for analytical gel filtration, and we do have multiple possibilities to determine endotoxin, and we even can do mass spec identification of an intact and deglycosylated antibody as a final quality control for your protein project. And after the project is completed, you will receive a full documentation of your project. So here is a document, a very basic documentation shown on this slide, which basically summarizes all the work that was done, all the material that was used. And of course, it also summarizes all the specifications of your protein that will be delivered to you, such as yield, concentration, endotoxin value, monomer status, whatever is requested by you start of the project. Again, this can be highly customized to your needs. And finally, I would like to share some customer examples, some customer success stories of our Gene2Protein service. So this slide basically is a case study where a biotech company who in-house explores novel antibody formats which are tested on their in-house immunotherapy platform. They were using the XP293 system for expression or purification of those antibody targets. However, they were looking for ways to increase productivity, and especially they wanted to increase their antibody production, and they wanted to reduce the hours a scientist spends by producing protein instead on focusing on actual research work. So what we did is we introduced our XPCHO expression platform to them, which immediately delivered them higher protein yields. However, still the scientists in the lab spent a lot of time by doing protein production instead of actual research. And this is when we introduced our Gene2Protein service, and by outsourcing those protein production projects, this certainly helped the customer to save time and produce relevant antibody targets in a very short turnaround time. So what the customer achieved was increased productivity with faster turnaround time on generated data, and they could approximately 50% of more proteins to be delivered simply by outsourcing this production of 90% of their proteins. And in sum, this saved basically more than 2,000 FTE hours a year. This is valuable time which could be spent by the scientists in the lab on doing actual research work. Another customer example is work that was actually carried out by a large pharma customer, and here actually the protein expression part was done in-house at the customer, as he wanted to use his in-house expression systems. However, he came to us, this customer came to us with very poor expression performance for a set of four monoclonal antibodies, basically with a non-existing performance. What we did is we optimized the heavy chain and light chain genes of those targets for expression in a CHO system. We sent those constructs back to the customer. He expressed them in-house, and he received a 22 to 650-fold increase in protein production levels. So basically, we made, simply by optimizing those targets, a non-expressor to a quite decent expressor. Another customer success story here for XP293 system, and for the sake of time, I'm just focusing on the table on the lower left here. Again, a customer came to us. He produced two antibodies in-house at titers of 2 mg/L. However, this customer was still using wild-type heavy and light chain genes. He was using the endogenous leader peptide, and he was using the conventional freestyle 293 system. So he outsourced the production of those two antibodies to us. We optimized the heavy and light chain genes, replaced the signal peptide, and switched to the XP293 system. And as you can see, we increased protein expression levels by a factor of more than 100. So here we made a very happy customer. And again, this substantial increase in expression levels is achieved by combining our gene optimizer technology with those advanced expression systems, which are offered through Thermo Fisher Scientific. And also, again, I would like to stress that those systems are commercially available, which provides full transferability of those processes and results for you as a customer. So in this next slide is another story where we tested the XPCHO system. So first in the middle of this slide is a nice example where you immediately can see how XPCHO outperforms other expression systems when we express a GFP protein. However, I would like to focus on the upper left figure, where again a customer came to us. He had a set of antibodies that he expressed in-house using the XP293 system. He achieved decent expression levels for a couple of those antibodies, but two antibodies showed actually no expression. He outsourced those proteins for production to us. We switched to the XP-CHO system, and we expressed those targets using the XP-CHO standard as well as the high titer protocol. And as reflected by the green bars, you can nicely see how protein expression levels were increased using the XP-CHO system in comparison to the XP293 expression level, which is highlighted by the blue bars. And especially, I would like to draw your attention again to those two targets, B and D, which are indicated here by those red circles. Both of them were basically non-expressor in the XP293 system, but after switching to XP-CHO, we achieved very decent expression levels up to 100 or 200 milligrams per liter, which is, of course, a significant value added. And I also want to say that overexpressing those proteins in the CHO system had no negative impact on the quality of those antibodies, as is simply reflected here on this SDS page, Kumasi stained shell, as well as on this HPLC analysis, which shows that monomer content of this antibody was above 95%, even without additional polishing after protein A purification. And yeah, this not only works for human IgGs, but it also works very well for other antibody-like formats such as FAPs or bispecifics, and as well for non-antibody formats, especially secreted epitope tagged non-antibody formats. Finally, I also would like to show you our newest service offering, which is a small-scale expression purification service in 24 to 96 multiple format. I mentioned it before, this is intended for customers who need initially only small amounts of protein, for example, for screening purposes. But what this slide shows is that also here we are using the XP-CHO system for the expression of antibodies, that this system is highly reliable and shows a high expression performance, constantly delivering up to 200 microgram of protein in a 96 well format and up to 500 microgram in a 20 well format. And yeah, based on first customer projects, we could deliver up to 500 microgram of protein for a 96 well production and up to 1.5 to 2 milligrams in a 24 well production. And what is shown on the lower left of this slide is basically simply conditioned media loaded on an SDS shell. You already can see the nice performance for antibody production in this 24 well format. And on the lower right, you can see how those antibodies will be delivered to you as the customer, as they will be purified using magnetic protein A magnetic beads. And this would be the deliverable for this service. So finally, again, I would like to stress that we offer here a full workflow solution, a highly customized service. And so we believe it's a very smart way for you as a customer to receive a highly expressed and purified protein in a quite short delivery time span. And I also want to mention that, obviously, along with your protein, you will also get the expression construct delivered for further in-house work. And I also want to mention that during each step of your project, you will be supported by a very dedicated and experienced project management team who will take care of your requests and questions even after a project already has been started. So to sum up, why should you partner with Thermo Fisher Scientific? You certainly can benefit by outsourcing protein production projects by at the same time getting access to commercially available reagents so you can replicate this work later in-house. It's a very consistent and high-performing process. We are experienced in the very very experienced in the full workflow from synthesis to gene synthesis to protein production, and we are using a world-class optimization algorithm that consistently improves protein expression yields. We have access to the highest titer systems on the market, which are the XP293 and XP-CHO media systems, and as they are produced by Thermo Fisher, you will not have to pay any additional licensing costs if you decide to outsource your protein production request. We are very flexible, ranging from high throughput expression of proteins up to large-scale production using Vive bioreactors. And of course, you will get full documentation, and you even can get a guaranteed amount of protein once a pilot project is performed. And with that, if this would be of any interest for your research, this slide simply shows how you could order GeneNut protein expression services. Simply go to thermofisher.com gene2protein, or simply contact your local sales representatives, or simply write directly an email to GeneNutProtein@thermofisher.com, and one of our project management representatives will immediately take care of your production request. And finally, I also would like to mention that we are at GeneNut in Regensburg. We are a zero-waste certified manufacturing site. Indeed, 0% of our waste goes to landfill, which is also something we are very proud of. And with that, I would like to finish this presentation, and yeah, would be happy to take your questions. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Fast, for your informative presentation and your time today. We would also like to thank LabRoots and our sponsor, Thermo Fisher Scientific, for underwriting today's educational webcast. We have a few polls we'd like to share with you that will display on your screen in just a moment. Your participation is greatly appreciated. If you are currently expressing protein in your lab, when do you plan to purchase custom gene synthesis services? In 1 to 3 months? In 3 to 6 months? In 6 months or more? I do not plan to purchase. Our next question, would you like to receive a quote for your next custom gene synthesis project? Yes or no? And our final question, would you like to be contacted by a technical sales specialist to understand more about our protein expression systems? Yes or no? And before we go, I'd like to thank the audience for joining us today and for their interesting questions. All questions submitted today and during the on-demand period will be addressed by our speaker via the contact information you provided at the time of registration. This webcast can be viewed on demand. LabRoots will alert you via email when it's available for replay. We encourage you to share that email with your colleagues who may have missed today's event. Until next time, goodbye.